Throw up your rock fist if you're feeling it when I drop this. Show them how we blow this pop. Let's make it hot. The shotgun with the body rock till the party stops. It's time to take it up a notch and keep it locked for oh, the headbangers in the parking lot. Here we come, if you're ready or not. No time to talk, cause we on the clock. Bringing that to your bluff. Let me show you where we coming from. And don't stop from LA to New York. Show me what you got.
Got a question for you that we get asked all the time. My name is Pastor Wood, my lady ministry.
Your name is?
Jasmine.
Jasmine?
Brittany.
I get asked this question all the time from people. They ask me a question because we go places like this all over the world. They say, how can somebody who loves God, that calls himself a Christian, how can they find themselves in a place like this having such a good time? Because the Bible says in James 4:4, it says that the friend of the world is the enemy of God. And so, can you tell these people? So, can you answer these people? Please don't be mad.
Why not?
It hurts my ear.
It's a fun whistle. Leave
me. Can you leave?
But it's fun.
I know, but we're not.
Why are you being mean to me? Y'all are Jesus people.
Y'all know her?
Jesus. I don't know her.
Y'all not with her? Okay. I can move her out of the way. I didn't want her to be y'all's friend. You're just being belligerent. Repent
Jesus
and believe the gospel.
I like you, lady.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. You're being belligerent. Okay, so the question once again to you is this. How can people that say that they love God and have a relationship be so friendly with the world? You don't know?
I love the Lord. Don't get me wrong. I'm a Christian.
Okay.
I really can't answer that question. I really don't know.
Okay, here's what the Bible says. It says that a friend of the world is the enemy of God. And he says if you say that you love him but don't keep his commands, he doesn't call you a Christian. It says that you're a liar and the truth's not in you. Revelation 21:8 says no liar will inherit the kingdom. He said this is how we know that we love him, if we keep his commands. He also said this in Revelation chapter 3, the church at Laodicea. Said, I've got a problem. You weren't hot or cold, but you were lukewarm. You compromised, so I'm going to vomit you out of my mouth. Matthew chapter 7 says this. It says, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom, but those that do the will of God. The will of my Father is in heaven is what it says. And so for you young ladies, you say you love God, right? You say you're a follower of him, but you're being a friend of the world, and the Bible would call you an enemy of God.
I didn't think that it was
wrong. You didn't know, did you? And so I'm just telling you what the word said. What we find is so many people, because chances are, Jasmine, you probably go to church pretty regular.
Every Sunday.
Let me ask you a question. Not counting Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, how many, on a regular basis, how many of those days a week do you think you actually pick up the Bible and read it?
I don't read it, but I pray almost every other night. I pray a lot.
And so you don't read the Bible?
I'm not going to lie. I don't.
I know.
I'm not going to lie.
You don't read it at all. Here's what the Bible says, okay? Ephesians chapter 2, it says that we're saved by grace through faith. We have faith in God. And listen to this. He said that faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. And without faith, it's impossible to please him. That we have to believe that he is, he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. And so I can go to church, but without faith it's impossible to please him. I can be good, but without faith it's impossible to please him. I can be friendly to my friends and not do anything evil, but it's impossible to please him. The only place that real faith can come from is God's word. But at your own admission, you don't even know what he says. And so if you don't even know what he said and what he requires, you really can't follow him, because here's what he said in Matthew 16. He said, if you want to be my follower, a Christian, you've got to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. So the reason that you struggle is because you just don't know what he says. That's just it. But look how neat this is. You girls are from here, right? I used to live here, but I live in Daytona Beach, Florida now. He loves you guys so much that he's willing to send me, who preaches all over the world, out here and say, come on, Jasmine. He loves you and you have a tender heart, but he wants you to really have a relationship with him. I didn't get your name, I'm sorry.
Brittany.
He said, I love you, Brittany, but I want to really genuinely know you. Because you just can't say that you know him but don't keep his commands. You've got to be a follower of Christ. But here's the good news, baby. He said this. He said, if you're faithful to confess your sins, then he's faithful and just to forgive you your sins and cleanse you of all unrighteousness. He hadn't forgot about you, and he wasn't waiting for you to go to church. He was waiting for you to come to him. He wants to know you. He wants to have a genuine relationship with you, one that's so precious to you. You say, man, God, I want to talk to you. I want to know what Jesus has to say about my life, about Jasmine, what he expects from me. And if you'll ask him to come genuinely into your life, what he said in the Word, he said, we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. We've all messed up. But he's made a way. If we're willing to repent and turn from that life and say, you know what, I didn't know before. But man, I thank God that Pastor Troy came and told me. And God, I'm not going to do what I did anymore. I'm not going to neglect reading the Word. God, would you forgive me and come into my life? You know what he'll do? He'll do that. He'll forgive you. If you'll ask him to come in, he will forgive you of those things. And he'll give you that hunger and that desire for his Word. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Here's what he said, Brittany and Jasmine. He said, if you're in Christ, you'll be brand new. All old things have passed away. All those things that you did, the mistakes you made, will pass away. And everything will become brand new. If you're in Christ, how do you get in Christ? You say, God, listen, evidently I missed it. I was religious, I went to church, but I understand now that it's got to be more than that. It's got to be something deeper. And God, that's what I desire. And would you forgive me and come into my life? If you'll ask him that, he'll do that. That's how sweet our Jesus is. Because I don't want you to go to hell. He don't want you to go to hell. So what does he do? He has us out here on Bourbon Street telling you this. Because wherever you're at, he's going to find you. How old are you? You're my daughter's age. My daughter just graduated from high school, 18 years old. And my prayer would, God, if she was struggling, didn't know, man, send another dad out there who would stop my baby and say, listen, sweetie, there's more. There's more Brittany, there's more Jasmine. And send them to pray with them and tell them the truth. So I'm here as a dad and a preacher. And as though you were my daughter, I'm telling you, just like I've told her for 18 years, God's got a big plan for you. He's got something for you, but it's going to take a genuine relationship with him. Do you want that? Y'all want to pray together tonight? Amen. I'm going to pray for y'all. Then I'm going to lead you in a prayer. I don't have a magic prayer, but I have a prayer if you're sincere in your heart. And if you'll ask God, he'll hear you, and he'll begin to do a work in you. Pray together. Father, I pray for Brittany, and I pray for Jasmine right now. And I thank you, Lord God, that I was just about ready to go home, but they stopped and said, what is it? Lord God, something's been happening in their life. And so, Father, tonight I pray for them, and I thank you for their tender hearts. They're precious, they're beautiful young ladies that you've got something so powerful for. So tonight, Lord God, I thank you that you're a forgiving God, that you love them, and you weren't willing for them, Lord God, to not know, that you'll send somebody to tell them. Girls, if you really want to do that tonight, pray this prayer. Say, Jesus, I'm sorry. I did not know. But tonight, I want to know. And I want you to be my Lord, my Savior, my friend, and my teacher. Tonight, Lord God, I ask you to forgive me. I haven't done right. I haven't lived right.
But tonight,
that changes.
Jesus,
cleanse me of everything that I did in the past. Tonight, Lord Jesus, I give my life to you. Thank you, Lord God, for sending Jesus to die for me and to rise from the dead. I believe it. What he did on the cross is my only hope, and I put my faith there tonight. Jesus, teach me your word. Cause me to understand that I'm going to serve you all the days of my life. Same struggles, the same things you're going through.